versus a big console game, and what's the difference between marketing one in Europe to one in South Korea?
And basically everything in mobile gaming moves much faster. And so marketing then for a console game would be marketing that's planned months ahead with a big marketing spending plan, and you choose carefully some months before in which media will your advertising appear. And basically in mobile, it's just you book some campaigns, you book them today, tomorrow you see the results, and then you iterate, and then you book some different campaigns and optimize. And the best companies in marketing for mobile games are the companies that can react super fast and the companies that are very number driven in the decision making they have. And I think that's a very different game than the old school console marketing.
So it's a data-driven approach, you're saying. Maybe you can give us a concrete example. Say I've made a game about little knights wanting to overrun little castles. And I want to get to a worldwide audience. What would you do to help me, concrete?
So basically you could just define a CPI initially that you're comfortable to spend, because you estimate...
Translate that maybe, the CPI.
A CPI is the cost per install. That's basically the cost you're willing to spend for one user we drive to your game. And then you decide on an initial territory where you test this game. Then you give us maybe 2,000 euros of your budget in this territory. We acquire your users. You immediately get a feedback on the quality of the users. So
let me jump in there. How do you do that? How do you acquire users? I don't want to give away.
So basically, we work with hundreds of partners, which can be gaming review websites, which can be other apps that are close to the apps you are looking to distribute. And basically, we are the partner that aggregates on one side all the partners that have media, and on the other side, we aggregate the game publishers that look for this media. And then we are an intermediary, making it efficient for game publishers to reach their audiences.
So you can judge the quality of the users that you bring? What does that mean?
Yes, so basically you can integrate us in your games. That means we get a feedback whenever a buyer, for example, one user you acquire through us, is doing a certain action in your game. For example, he's paying. And then we can give you feedback on which channels that we use work best for your audience. And then you can adjust and say, like, we don't want so much traffic of channel one because it's not monetizing well, but give us more of channel three, and we are willing to increase the payout there to drive you more traffic. And I think this is in the end the direction where things are going, that you adjust the payment for the users you acquire to the quality level of the players you get. And basically this way, make sure that your games attract a high and well monetizing audience. Or you could also connect that basically to the virality of your users. So you attract only super viral users, where in the end, if you acquire one user, you get two free on top, because those users just spread the word about your game.
How much is a user?
Ballpark. Typically, it's between $1 and $4. So the typical currency there is dollars, because in the end it's all driven the US as the largest market. And in that range, the largest publisher acquired about 1 million users with us in 1 month.
Yeah, obviously this is a tremendous development. It's a way, way far away from the old gaming market where you made a game, put it in a box, and shipped it to stores. Hendrik, is it in a market that's mature like this, where you have the technology and you have the data, is it more difficult these days to get a mobile game out there and be successful with it, or has it become harder?
It is definitely much more difficult than it is.